doesn't make sense and is unsustainable. We cannot support it. Going on to the Tory amendments, I mean, you know, Anne and others have made points about the lack of fairness, in the way the cuts have been made. You know, it is, you know, every objective analysis shows that the areas of the north, like Wirral, have been penalised unfairly. So I won't kind of repeat that. But I mean, I just wanted to pick up a couple of points that Jeff made about the first of all about the transformational change programme, because we had this debate at the leaders' board of course last Friday. And the trouble with Jeff is he actually wants to be the chief executive of this department. I'm convinced he wants to be the chief executive.
I want to say Christmas card.
Because the reality is, Mr. Mayor, that there are business plans, there are project plans in place. They will be published. We were told on Friday they'll be published in January. You'll be able to scrutinise and ask questions. But to get into the minutiae and the operational detail is not, I would argue, the job of us as elected members. We set the direction of the travel, we set the policy, we monitor the outcomes, but we don't micromanage this authority. That's what we pay the chief exec and the senior officers to do. And he needs to understand the difference between the two roles. And then he criticises me for getting rid of the, or for not going along with his recommendation that we have all sorts of boards to monitor all these things, which he sits on. The reason why I did that, Mr. Mayor, is that he actually lost the council election last year, in 2012, and Councillor Green is no longer the leader of the council. On Councillor Cox's contribution, Tony, I'm really glad that you've had time to come to Wirral to have a break from your duties as parliamentary candidate for the Tories. Well, not on the council of the line. He talks about 13 years of overspending by the last Labour government. I am proud of the record of the last Labour government. New schools, new hospitals, new surgeries.
All those in favour, please show. passed. Versus 26. Thank you. We now move on to the next one, which is the recommendation in respect of minutes 117, council based tax.
So move.
No, I'll.
Yes, I have. All those in favour of the Conservative amendment, please show. All those against? That was lost. 21, 41. All those in favour. I beg your pardon. Somebody shout. Item 7, pages 51 to 80 of the agenda, concerning the report of the legal executive manager's policy performance checks. The council is invited to receive and open the floor. All questions must be confined.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Could beg your indulgence. May save council time if I indicate that my group are minded to support both the Liberal Democrat amendments on this item and the Tory amendments. But can I just very briefly say, clearly I wasn't at the meeting a couple of weeks ago, but I'm aware that there was at least diplomatically some confusion about the paperwork. Clearly, where there is any sort of question or doubt about whether members have all the information available at the time, I am happy to agree that it's going to be looked at again, so that every member's got the opportunity to properly digest and understand what's being mooted. In terms of, so happy to support that. It's just a really comment really on the Conservative amendment, which again, I have not thought about from the time period back. Just highlight an issue that we discussed at the Leaders' Board on Friday, that we, the three leaders agreed that the draft questionnaire, which is currently being prepared, should be signed off by the Standards and Constitutional Oversight Committee. So I'm just wondering if there may be a need for a special meeting early in the new year for that committee to do that. And I'm very happy to support that, but that's just an additional element that I would propose.
From the leader of council, is that agree?
Agree.
Thank you. Now we move on to item 7. Council invited to receive the notice of report. All questions will be confined to the relevant members. Bill, would you like to?
I just move my report. Mr. Mayor, I'm happy to answer your questions.
Applications for legal counsel, obviously. In the corporate plan mentioned in the report, in your report, Phil, legal counsel refers to its success in changing the council's culture. Is he aware of a technical report produced as recently as August this year? scheme in which it is alleged that senior members of administration A, using language about senior officers that are acceptable, B, encouraging former council employees to swear in, to take pressure off his own colleagues and gain political advantage. If he is aware, what actions have he taken? And what does this say for his assertion of culture is changing in his group?
I'm just asking you to take some advice that whether or not legal counsel can be asked to comment on and unsubstantiated rumour.
Well, that's why I asked different questions. Are you aware of it? Is he aware of it?
Believe are unsubstantiated rumours. I think it would be wise for the
will take that legal advice and I'll wait till that point to take that advice.
Councillor Glassman, yes, I would join with you in congratulating the staff, the manager and everyone associated with the Merseyside Pension Fund for winning the best nationally environmentally sustainable award, Global Government Chronicle Awards recently. It is the latest in a long line of awards that our pension fund has won. I think it demonstrates the extremely efficient way that the fund continues to be managed. And I can actually place on my record my personal thanks to myself, Captain Gatson, as chair of the Pensions Committee, for the excellent way in which you've steered that committee over the last year. In response to Councillor Jean Stapleton, the Sagoma figures I think are shocking. I think that they do, I think, in very stark terms, illustrate the disparity between the way cuts have affected different parts of the country. And I was really taken with an article in the press last week, which showed that the UK's largest local authority, Birmingham City Council, has made savings of £840 million between 2010 and 2018. And they're saying now that they will not be able to meet even their statutory commitments. So I do hope the party opposite, and I hope the government will listen to the very real concerns, not just in Wirral. This is not just a Wirral issue. This is an issue of many authorities in the North and the Midlands. And I do hope that at some point in the new year they will have a meeting. So, but I think we need to watch this space. Councillor Mark Johnson, can I just say to Mark that clearly the scrutiny review that he chaired and reported in, I think, in April of this year, did make a number of recommendations to Council on how the authority was responding to the impact of welfare reform in respect of access to housing, the bedroom tax and other issues. The report made 18 recommendations for various areas for the Council to review and look to implement, and the scrutiny committee recommended that a further report be presented and indicated that a follow-up should be made in spring 2014. And Cabinet, I think, received the report in June and agreed recommendations and referred it to our MPs as well. And clearly, the last council, my group moved the motion, which highlighted the damaging impact that the bedroom tax is having on our residents. And I'm really grateful to Councillors Gilchrist, Councillor Williams, for not able to be here tonight. But I think we had a productive initial meeting on what we can practically do to help, particularly our residents who are suffering as a result of the bedroom tax. We've got a meeting in Barry later this week, and I'm hoping that we will at least be able to agree the outlines of an action plan. But I want to assure Mark that it's absolutely right that we don't lose sight of those important recommendations that the History Committee, when he was chair, made, and that we do have an obligation to report back on what the outcome of those recommendations are. I know that there's been a number of detailed areas of progress since April, which I'll write you separately, Mark, about it. I've not time to go into them about tonight. But it is important, I mean, in general, I think it is important when the scrutiny committee goes to the trouble of doing a piece of work like that, there's a lot of scrutiny reviews taking place at the moment, that those recommendations, once they've been published, are tracked, and we do make sure that we don't lose sight of that work, because it is vital work, and certainly part of the new kind of regime that we try to put around having a more effective scrutiny process. So we will, on any action plan, just given the reassurance, on any action plan that we produce as a result of the meeting of Phil and Ian and myself, we will make sure that we don't lose sight of those important recommendations from your scrutiny committee. And then finally, Councillor Blakely's comments. I mean,
sorry, question.
Sorry,
do apologise.
About the 35 million. This is, in my view, and I've taken advice from our sort of treasury experts, this is good practice within local government. Local councils lend money, which they're not using at any one particular time in the year, to lots of other local councils. Rural is not alone in doing this. And indeed, the Municipal Journal recently cited Wirral as an example of good practice in how we conduct ourselves in doing this. So there's nothing out of the ordinary. And in fact, you know, we eventually made official funding from the money we lent out. And try and answer your question, please. It's good practice. Local authorities up and down the country do it. And we've been complimented by the Municipal Journal as an example of a local authority that does this particularly well. So I am, you know, I've got no problems with the way we've done this. I think that's it. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you very much. Council, some questions to note that, of course. That's okay. We now move on to the Cllr portfolio for the full solution. Questions, Councillor Jones? Yes. Please stand up.
I have a seasonal question for Councillor Harry Smith.
Oh, sorry, we're not up to Harry Smith yet. We're dealing with the Cabinet Member for Adult Social Care. I take it there are no questions. Everybody have to know that before. Thank you. Next one. I'll leave you with the other question. Council Support Services, any questions? Sorry, no.